Mani Doraisamy. I'm the founder of Guesswork, a machine learning startup. We help CRM companies to build predictive intelligence in their product. There's a lot of buzz around machine learning and big data nowadays. I want to talk about how it impacts ordinary users. If you think about successful products, they have three elements working together very well. Software, infrastructure, which runs that software, and then the users who make it useful, right? If you think about CRM, for example, Salesforce disrupted the CRM market by combining two of these elements, the software and the infrastructure portion of it. And thus, SaaS was born, software as a service was born. We think the next big CRM will be the one that combines user intelligence along with software as a service. Think about how salespeople interact with software today. That kind of intelligence will be built inside the software. This is something that every business software will have in the next decade. This predictive intelligence that machine learning offers will augment human intelligence and make software more intelligent. If you think about CRM, CRM records every interaction about customers. But even with that wealth of data, it still doesn't understand what customers want. But on the other hand, think about what Google does in search and AdWords. It understands customer intention with a few keywords they type in search box, and that makes it the largest business in the world. Now it's time that CRM learns from what Google does and then does the same kind of customer intention prediction inside CRM. With the launch of Google Prediction API, Google has opened up that secret sauce as to how it predicts customer intention to the developers. At Guesswork, we have taken Google Prediction API and we have simplified it just for one use case, for one vertical, to predict customer intention for CRM type of applications. Also, we have built a rule engine on top of Prediction API because most of these prediction about customer intention are kind of a combination of both rules as well as machine learning. So we have built that rule engine to improve accuracy on top of Google Prediction API. So I'm going to show you a demo of how you can use Guesswork to predict customer intention and also personalize customer interaction. So let's take an example where a customer sends you an inquiry or a feedback, and then we want to understand what that inquiry is all about and automatically respond to those inquiries. So by doing that, you can make the salespeople more productive, but at the same time, by understanding what customers are asking, you'll be able to understand what the customer intention is. So you will understand what kind of products he likes or if he is most likely to stay with your company or is he going to churn out. So that's the demo that we're going to show. So here is our dashboard. So I'm going to click on New Project. So once I click on New Project, you can select one of these three templates that you already have. So let's name this project as Autobot. And let's select the Auto Response Engine template. And once you click Next, you can see the design screen. Here, you get the customer's feedback as the input, and we are going to predict three information. So for example, let's say a customer gives a feedback saying the food was good. Now, in that case, we predict that the category of this feedback is food, and the property is quality, and the type of the feedback is price, right? So based on these three predictions, we're going to say what should be the feedback that the customer representative or the salesperson should do. So let's click on Next. So this gives you a screen where you can upload the training data. In this case, we're going to leave it to the default training data. So Guesswork automatically comes up with a sample set of training data to populate the project. So once I click on Publish in the fourth screen, Guesswork automatically creates the machine learning project underneath. So it uses Google Prediction API and then creates the classification algorithm that's needed for it, and also creates the rule engine that's needed to automatically respond to these inquiries or feedback. So now that this is published, I can go and click on Test. So let's see how that works. So I'm going to click on Run. So now you can see the try it out screen. Here I can give a feedback saying food was good. And when I click on test, you can see that it automatically predicts that the category is food, property as quality, and type as price. And it automatically comes up with a response saying, we are glad that you enjoyed the food. Hope we get an opportunity to serve you again. So that's the demo. So what you saw was the ability to automatically respond to the inquiry and improve the productivity of the sales staff or the customer service representative. But at the same time, by understanding what the customers are speaking about, which product is he talking about, and whether he is pricing the product or complaining about the product, you know exactly what the customers want so that salespeople can upsell or cross-sell new products to the customers from the CRM. I want to conclude with two predictions about the future of predictive intelligence. Now, RelateIQ acquisition by Salesforce has caused huge interest in machine learning in CRM space. We think other business software verticals will follow suit, be it healthcare, HR, law, or any other software verticals. The second one we think will happen is that as machine learning infrastructures like Google Prediction API flourish, vertical services like Guesswork will emerge because there is a lot of need to fulfill machine learning needs in business-specific verticals. So we think that will happen in future. Thanks for listening. This is Mani Doraisamy from Guesswork.